I started writing letters to and from Garrett about 60 years ago, but I didn't meet him until maybe 1962, 63, when I drove up to Gloucester. He was two kinds of teacher, and I want to stress his teacherliness. Our Puerto Rican friend mentioned the word mentor, and Garrett was certainly that. But the two kinds I'm thinking of is the kind of teacher who tells you, "You're right, kid, just keep going, you'll get there." And that's an important kind of teacher, the one who says, "Stop worrying, just do it, just do it." The other kind of teacher is the one who actually teaches you something. And Garrett was good at that too. And I wanted to tell you one thing that I learned from him that has haunted me ever since, and that is his doctrine of the cycle of sevens. That every 7 years, we go through a gate that changes the nature of our lives. From 0 to 7, what happens? You know that. When I was a Catholic child, I was told, when you're 7 years old, you can commit sins. Before 7, no sin, because you don't know what you're doing. But after 7, the age of reason begins. Imagine that, the age of reason begins at 7. Tell that to your children, your grandchildren, or your great-grandchildren. Who are we? 7 to 14, at 14 you will become bat mitzvah. Get confirmed, different things happen. At 21, you can get drunk legally and vote in those days. And so, think of the things, the gateways of the seventh. Garrett laid that out for me very carefully. And I was at first reluctant, as you might be, and thinking of the artificial symmetry, because where in the world do you find symmetry like that? Well, I've lived with that for years and years and years. I'm about to approach next year yet another 7 gateway, the one where people usually die at 84. That's the great death gate. If you get through that, you live forever. And alas, God, just on the verge of his 90th birthday, as if thumbing his nose at his old doctor, because we do not live by our doctrine alone. But the doctrine moved me very much because it told me something about the nature of, well, education, of learning. I was roughly 7 years younger than Garrett, so I could learn from him. That 7-year gap sets up a very interesting thing. George is sort of 7 years younger than me. He could learn from me if he but the sense that we carry for the world, at that 7-year gap between one person and another, something happens. There's an electricity, a real feeling. George and I have known each other for many, many years, and we go up and down and in and out, that feeling persists. And I think it has something to do with Garrett's marvelous cycle of sevens. Think about it. I just wanted to read one poem that I found, that Charlotte found for me in some of the papers for Garrett. For Garrett Manson. Poetry is being close to what isn't even there, with wings celebrating mysterious arrivals, like friends who suddenly come to mind, a face out of the dark, some low church hymn tune, or mothers that at this cold light, confused, mysteriously fly close to the windshields of moving car. And later, we remember only the muddy glance of them as they passed. They're safe now, But what was the message they tried so hard to describe? Was it something about speed itself, or boy being in a car, or going somewhere? Where do we go? Phones ring, I answer, I listen, I talk, I forget. Those are not the golden verses you prophesy when our infant America finally comes of age, and all those hard flickering lights come past us, and the lights in our eyes light up, the ones you say, the whirling intimate lights, you tell me are called phosphenes, and say they make spirals. I believe you. I believe your words. You know the world that is to come, the world made 93% of pure light. It will come, it will come, because you listened to the pulse of everything, the music built into our ears, word by word, by antique woodcuts and the taste of salt. You helped me to become what I saw. You helped me to name what I thought, what I see. You help me see fresher image of the Lord of the world, blue Jupiter of the tarot cards, or the form I glimpsed once, a sleeping man of middling years, strong, his chest rising, falling gently in his dream. Gerrit's reincarnation is probably now about 6 months old. I don't know where he or she is. I hope we meet her, him. I hope he might even be here, close. But certainly when the new Gerrit comes along, treat him better than we treated the last one. We left him living in Boston, Massachusetts. Too many years. Thank you,
Gary. Well, thank you, Robert. Can you play a bit? Is that right? Yeah, but I'm going to play a bit.